Hello friends, in this video lecture we will see working of network layer with its services and responsibilities. We are familiar with some facts associated with network layer, that network layer is the third layer in OSI reference model from the bottom. Network layer is responsible for the source to destination delivery of packet, possibly across multiple networks. We will see this source to destination delivery in the upcoming slides. Network layer ensures that each packet gets from its point of origin to its final destination. Means packet which is sent from the source should be received there at the receiver end. Network layer is also responsible for the delivery of individual packets from the source host to the destination host. Let's say if two systems are attached to different networks with connecting devices between these two networks. So in that case, there is need of network layer to accomplish source to destination delivery. Means your sender is there in one network and your receiver is there in another network. So to send data from sender to receiver, there is need of network layer. And to connect these two networks, we need some networking devices like router, switch, hub, etc. So here is diagram of network layer before you. So at sender side, network layer receives data from transport layer and sends data to data link layer. And at receiver end, network layer receives data from data link layer and sends data to transport layer. Let's see sender side first. At sender side, network layers receives data from the transport layer, which is upper layer, by means of interlayer communication. Means in this case, network layer uses the services provided by transport layer. And whatever the data is received there at network layer is known as packets. So at network layer, data is there in the form of packets now. This network layer adds header H3 to data 3 and sends that complete data, that is complete packet, to lower layer, that is data link layer, by means of interlayer communication. Now here in this case, network layer, that is upper layer, provides services to the lower layer, which is data link layer. Now at receiver side, there is reverse mechanism. Network layer receives data from data link layer, which is lower layer, by means of interlayer communication. Means this network layer uses services provided by the data link layer. After receiving data, that is packet, at the network layer removes header 3, that is H3, from the data 3, that is in the form of packet now, and sends that remaining data to the transport layer by means of interlayer communication. Means here in this case, network layer provides services to the upper layer, that is transport layer. Now let's see services or responsibilities provided by network layer. First one is the logical addressing. Here in logical addressing, network layer adds header to the packet coming from the upper layer, that is transport layer. Now after receiving packets here, network layer adds some information that includes logical addresses of the sender and the logical addresses of the receiver. And we need logical addresses when packet passes network boundaries, that is network link. Here in this diagram, you can see that there is a system A. Here in this case, link is referred as network boundary. System A is there in one network and system B is there in another network. To connect these two networks, we need networking devices. This logical addressing is also known as IP addressing, that uses IP addresses, that is Internet Protocol addresses. We will see Internet Protocol addresses in the upcoming videos. Next responsibility is the routing. When independent networks or links are connected to create internetworks or a large network, the connecting devices, which are actually intermediate devices or the networking devices like router, switches, route or switch the network to their final destination. And one more responsibility is there, that is source to destination delivery. Let's see this source to destination delivery. Here in this case, you can see there is end system, which is A. We call this as a sender, and we are having another system, that is F, which is receiver or the destination. So system A is there in one network and system F is there in another network. These two networks are connected by the intermediate system, that is router. This one is router B and this is router E. Here link is referred as network boundary. In system A is connected to intermediate system B with the help of this network boundary. This intermediate system B is connected to intermediate system E with the help of this network boundary. And this system E is connected to end system F with the help of another network boundary. Here you can call this as link or the network boundary. Same is the case with link between B and C. This is also network boundary, and one more network boundary is there between intermediate system C and the D. Now when sender A wants to send data to receiver F, then network layer at A sends a packet to the network layer at B. Means flow of data is here like this. Means at A, network layer sends data to data link layer. Data link layer sends data to physical layer. And physical layer of this A is connected with physical layer of the intermediate system, that is B. Now here, physical layer of B sends data to data link layer of B, and data link layer of B sends data to network layer of B. Now in this case, there is communication between A and B. And when packets arrive at B, router makes a decision based on the final destination F of the packet. And here router B uses his routing table to find the next hop, that is E. Means network layer of B sends data to network layer of E through data link layer, physical layer of B. Physical layer of B is connected with physical layer of E. Physical layer of E sends data to data link layer through vertical communication. And after receiving data at E, E uses its routing table and sends data to its data link layer, that is within system. There is sending of data from network layer to data link layer of E and from data link layer to physical layer of E. And physical layer of E is directly connected with the physical layer of F, that is next hop. And after receiving data at physical layer of receiver, that is F, data sends to data link layer, that is upper layer. And after that, data link layer sends data to network layer. So in this manner, data is received there at F. Means B takes decision based on the routing table of B, and E also takes decision based on the routing table of E. So this type of communication is known as सोर्स टू डेस्टिनेशन डिलीवरी. हियर यू कैन से डिलीवरी बिटवीन ए एंड बी इज नोन एज हॉप टू हॉप डिलीवरी. डिलीवरी बिटवीन बी एंड ई इज ऑल्सो नोन एज हॉप टू हॉप डिलीवरी. And delivery between E and F is also known as hop-to-hop delivery. Means delivery or the communication between two adjacent system is known as hop-to-hop. And delivery between two end system, that is from source to destination, is known as end-to-end delivery or source to destination delivery. This source to destination delivery is performed by network layer. And this hop-to-hop delivery is performed by data link layer. We will see this hop-to-hop delivery in the video lecture of data link layer. So in next video lecture, we will see working of data link layer with its services. Thank you for watching. For more such videos, stay connected here with this channel. Thank you.